So, hello everybody, welcome back to Sanitarium with your host WizWorld 100, and here with me, as always, is...
Hitman again, yay.
So we're finally going to see the part that you never got to see because your game crashed.
Well, I don't know if it crashed or if I just gave up.
I know I gave up.
Or if I, like, reformatted my computer or something, I'm not sure, actually. I lost the save.
Yeah, I actually stopped here. Like, I played for a little bit, but, like, we were having that long session where we were both playing, and this is where I stopped.
Yeah.
So now we're in the... If you remember, we went through time because Mr. Morgan jumped through an architect thing.
Yeah, we're Quetzalcoatl or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, Olmec.
Olmec's great. He's pretty funny. To be merely a vision, but here you stand, Olmec,
the holy warrior. Praise the gods. Although she seems off, way too excited about that.
Olmec?
Yeah.
Forgive me. My name is TTO.
He has this weird lilting voice. Like, Olmec, the great warrior.
So this is what happens when someone famous goes to a convention they were invited to.
Yeah.
One day this will be me.
Same.
It'll just be, it's, instead of Olmec, it'll be WizWar. I have been summoned.
Yeah, it'll be old ladies getting way too excited that you're there.
Old cosplayers. Right, it's like by the time I'm like 100 years old, it's like, oh, finally,
what?
Recognition. What?
Oh, I was just listening to Olmec talk.
He says some funny things later on in this video, too.
If you speak the truth, then I must see him. Where is he?
And look at his face. His face is kind of like unintentionally funny to me.
Yeah.
Because it looks like a cat.
Or bird.
I see a cat face on him. But his like avatar looks really goofy too.
The Jaguar Temple still stands.
Oh, and oh, I gotta say something. There's gonna be a lot of speeding up in this video because I missed something very crucial that caused me to run around the map thinking like, what am I doing wrong when in fact I'm just missing a certain part of it?
Yeah.
So yeah, just to note that. This video is an hour and 17 minutes long, but that should be fine. Actually, this also combines with a later clip, too, I believe.
Okay, so Quetzalcoatl showed up to this village and killed everyone. Or, he's killing people when he's doing bad stuff, so we gotta go stop him.
Yes, that's why they summoned Olmec, too. And I think those four can stop, like, bowing right now. But no, they're just gonna keep bowing for the rest of the game.
Okay.
To battle their foe has driven them mad. They rant only crazed things in the voices of God.
Well, we have our work cut out for us here. Goodbye.
The Wall of Sorrow. Images which tell the story of this village.
Are we gonna get a closer look at it, or? I guess
nope.
Not.
Nope, nothing important at all. Just our entrance into this world. And they never ever say goodbye in this game. It's just goodbye, just like leave.
I shall get to my duties. No, it's just like they spout and evil ghost speak. Okay, and he just leaves.
You know, this place almost looks like a dark or demons' soul there. Actually, I guess Dark Souls would make more sense.
Yeah, the dude's rocking back and forth on the top of the waterfall there.
It's a dead soul. Maybe his bloodstain will tell you something, which it will. Okay. Actually, it's pretty much like in Dark Souls, where they tell you, like, what happened to them.
Yeah.
Oh.
Quit, get cursed so you can kill him.
We'd have to jump over the waterfall. Oh, and then there's a puzzle later on with all the ghosts you find in this, and I somehow managed to figure it out.
Huh.
Everyone watching can join in on that.
So this guy's something to do with shame?
Oh, it's just like how he died. He's been ashamed because,
Mixcoatl?
Mixcoatl.
Huh.
That's a weirdish name.
I'm not really feeling that name.
It's feeling a little mixed on that. Anyways, this world makes like... It's kind of confusing because Dr. Morgan's also here somewhere because he jumped through the thing and we're also here. But
right.
I'm not sure how it connects to the next area. I know the significance of it, but I don't know why.
Did he come through as Quetzalcoatl?
Good guess. Yes, that's pretty much actually, that's what it should be implying. But they never say.
Right, because we show up as a god, and he shows up as a god as well. Only he's evil, so he's the evil god.
They have honored Quetzalcoatl with this statue, and he repays them with...
I thought Quetzalcoatl was like this giant snake thing.
They have
Maybe metaphorically, he's a snake. Which, Morgan kind of is.
He too has been slain by the evil Quetzalcoatl.
He's evil. Oh, this guy's got an axe.
Spirit, what say you?
Oh, that'll, like, go through the, enemy's, what was it? Their threshold.
Could not defeat one.
Maybe we'll get buffed by the strength rating.
I can see you've got a backwards mouth on, Olmec here.
And after that, I put it away, because it just does not work.
No, you'd be good to be talking to this side of his mouth.
You were the war chief?
Like in, like when that kid with two mouths did.
Yeah, exactly. Did the mouths have different voices? I forget.
What was your station as warriors?
No, they don't.
Okay, he just asked if he was the war chief, and now he's asking him what his station was. He just told you that he was the war chief, after you asked him that he was the war chief.
Our god, ladies and gentlemen!
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of dumb stuff where you can ask them, like, what they are, and then you ask them again.
Yeah.
Defeated by only one man.
Last man standing.
Scalding lake of lava.
So they did it, so they all got beat by one man at once.
Scalding lake of lava.
Scalding lake of lava.
I like Olmec's voice. This is so
why?
Funny.
I better not cross that. Like, why does he just say scalding lake? He has no other observation.
Seems to be a piece of something greater.
Nope, just one observation, because this is back then with the... with, like, you know, the description of text.
A tree growing in the lava.
I would like to see a not scalding lake of lava. A cool lake of lava.
This
water here is dirty.
Many have been sacrificed on this spot. Some for good, some for evil.
I assume he's just guessing for that.
Yeah.
In the fist of the evil god.
Yeah. I guess Dr. Morgan's, like, 5 minutes ago that he showed up here was equivalent to several months.
Oh, god.
Big head.
It's kind of like that episode...
Thanks, Olmec.
Captain Obvious. The god of obvious.
That's his power. He can understand things that a basic human child can understand.
That does not need to be said. Anyways, going about the time thing, it's kind of like that episode in the Justice League when Kronos, like, jumped, like, seconds before the Justice League followed, but he's already been in the place for, like, 6 months.
Huh. I don't think I ever saw that episode.
That's a good, like, episode saga to go through, because they also go into Batman Beyond, and that was a really cool part, but... sad, but it was a cool part.
Huh.
Because basically, Chrono fucks up time because he's trying to control everything, so Green Lantern turns into Hal Jordan.
Huh.
And it's just like, everyone's like, oh, this is giving me a migraine.
What was your station as
yeah.
Spirit?
I don't know, Justice League Unlimited, because I just rewatched all the Justice League episodes.
Oh, yeah, it's in Justice League Unlimited. Because there's more heroes.
Ah, that one was pretty bad. Unlimited? It just did not,
doomed as long as I draw breath.
Not interest me very much.
Oh, really?
It was very like Monster of the Week-ish, unlike the original Justice League, which had like two episode runs.
Or basically a real big crisis.
Yeah, where usually it was like a major villain, and they were always interesting. Like I can't remember a thing that I didn't, or an arc that I didn't enjoy in Justice League.
Well, personally, I enjoyed both, but Justice League had more closure than Unlimited. Unlimited like had this thing where like a bunch of questions were still left for answering.
Well, Darkseid just shows up and he's like, anti-life equation, yay.
I'm the bad guy.
What name did you go by in this world, Fallen Hero?
Fallen Hero. To TikTok, to TikTok.
Almost sounds like TikTok.
Tic-tac-toe,
TikTok.
Clock man.
Yeah, so talking to these ghosts are very important because they give you information. Some of them are, like, relevant to the puzzles. Actually, they all are, but a few of them
and
are
part-time video editor.
Why do you stand here, fallen one?
Like what the one they call Wizwar, who will be editing this.
Fisherman, warrior, husband, father,
video gamer,
firefighter.
Oh god, firefighter simulator. I kind of want that game.
Occasional reader.
Half-time food eater.
I guess just say everything that describes you all at once.
Well, Olmec wants all the information so he can be really obvious.
Quetzalcoatl is my enemy as well. This man is a warrior and a fisherman.
Wait, so Olmec has to get through this area, but a ghost is blocking him. I don't know what stops him. Because he can't do
maybe
anything.
Maybe he just wants to be nice to the ghost.
Or maybe he's afraid of ghosts.
Oh, the Olmec's afraid of anything.
Who are you gonna call? Ghostbusters?
Olmec! Oh. What?
That's his one regret, never giving him the gift to his wife.
You wanted to give the gift of a wife to someone?
A gift for your wife? What is a wife?
A necklace? Simple enough. I will find one for her and...
Someone's been having fun with the voice editing.
Yeah, I don't like this. Is this crafted for her? Prove be words true. Just have him talk. Like, this is so cumbersome.
I mean, I get why they're doing it, but there's just too many words.
I meant her name.
It's so clear, and it just—it's really obvious they're saying.
I meant her name, bitch. Tell me her name.
Does she look like a bitch?
What he needs to know her name, but he won't give it to us because, like, we might harm her.
Oh, is this one of the things where you have to like put them in order?
Oh, you saw the age thing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to put six of them in order, and their names are all like Mixquatl, Texaqui,
Omitoik,
shoot your dick, and I can't believe I managed to solve it without writing it down because I was going to write it down.
Yeah, that seems like the obvious thing you have to do is write it down, but... Because they're clearly saying, like, I am older than this guy, but young, and then this guy's, like, the war chief, so he must be the oldest.
And clearly, it's obviously a puzzle somewhere if you've played any video game in your life.
Yeah.
Why do you weep so?
Woman, why do you weep?
Forgive me, I love that. For not showing you the proper
sounds so official.
But I am racked with grief over the loss of my husband. He died in the battle with Quetzalcoatl.
Put the mouth over her face.
She looks so happy. Look at her. So placid.
Yes, not sad at all.
To Pick-Tock.
Well, that was easy to find her.
He was a warrior. He was also a fisherman. And he was my husband.
And he was a father to my child.
And he was a citizen of this village.
And did we mention he's a warrior?
I think we did.
He's also a living being. Or at least he was.
He's also insane.
He also talks really slowly. That was not an effect. It was what he did in real life.
Yeah, this... I guess all the men talk like that in order so that everyone can, so that they can be more official. Like, the more stuttery your voice is, the like, it's like a sign of masculinity.
It must have been used for sacrifices.
Kind of sounds like the idiot, like, my
an empty copper bowl must have been used for sac. Okay, Olmec. Maybe it was used to carry water.
Or anything, like food.
A truly venerable woman scraping out that pot there. As a woman should do.
What say you?
Woman, does that pot carry anything?
The oracle was successful in summoning you. Although at this point, I don't see much use in it. The damage has been done. You have no purpose here.
What fuck you, bitch. I'm here and I'm here.
It's a crone.
I fight for the gods themselves.
You sound as zealous as my husband, the fool.
You calling me a joker?
What man would be mad enough to wed your sour tongue, old woman?
Who's crazy enough to marry your stupid bitch ass mouth?
The witch is my husband.
The witch is her. Isn't a witch usually a woman?
Yes, but apparently a witch has doesn't have a defined gender, but usually it refers to a female. But in this case,
I thought it was witch and warlock, like a warlock was a man.
Well, think about this, Hitman. What would you call a witch doctor a female all the time? Like, they could be male.
It would be like shaman. Oh, witch doctor is like gender neutral. So it's like I don't know about shaman though. The undead king.
Where are your two sons?
Oh no, the wrath of the Lich King?
Yes.
Oh god, if this turns into World of Warcraft, I'm turning it off.
Their bodies as though they were made of straw.
Thankfully no, except for the clicking part.
My husband will join them, and I'll be truly alone.
What is that you are mixing?
Nothing important, holy
one. But it said potion.
Just a simple balm.
How did you know it was a potion?
Age has not been kind to me.
Age has not been kind to me. Goodbye! Look how he's just strutting so officially.
He's the slowest character in the game next to Sarah.
Yeah.
You there, what is your station?
I was the stonemason. Now I am village chief. What are you? And why do you enter this village?
I am Olmec, holy warrior. You dare address me in that tone?
He just asked you a question.
You may frighten the others.
It'd be nice if you could, like, just punch him out. From me.
Where were you when we needed you most?
Unfortunately, that's not an option. To me.
You're too late.
I guess you need him for something?
You say I am late, but you are wrong.
I am super late.
So, my precious daughter lies crushed beneath these rocks. The day Quetzalcoatl arrived, I prayed to your god with all my heart. Can you come to us now? The warriors are dead. The temples are in ruins.
I didn't get to the time machine.
You say your daughter
is
dead.
This thing called a time travel. I had to, I was just 5 minutes late.
Death is everywhere. I've lost everything that is dear to me.
I really needed to use the bathroom.
That's true.
Yes, that is my trade.
Like I was taking a nice cold nap before. You see, I was in this thing called a cryo chamber, and you know what? Fuck it.
There was a tree that really needed to be talked to.
There are worse fates, Mason.
And I had to solve a stupid puzzle involving heating up a room.
I had to burn I had to incremate a man so I can steal his eyeball. Wait, why are you looking at me like that? Oh, the eyeball thing.
I had to procure the eye of an old man to unlock the secrets of the
tree.
Nah, never mind.
And then I had a weird thing where there was a lag. This thing that causes me to see myself a little later.
I'm not really sure where they're going with that.
Mason,
but this is very significant.
I have spoken with the spirit of Tepetok, warrior and
Tepetok.
You know, I don't know.
Kalkihut?
His spirit remains here?
Yes. You have the necklace that belongs
I'm wondering, like, can they not talk to the ghost, or is it just only Olmec? I'm gonna assume it's just because it's Olmec.
Very well. Tell your spirit I will deliver his gift.
Or I will shatter your limbs like twigs.
And I will keep bashing
this
wall.
Did he really have to go to that immediately? Could have just said, deliver it to her.
Worry so? Woman,
well, it is Olmec.
Olmec.
That's how I talk to girls, actually.
I'm gonna shatter your knees.
No, I go, woman, what say you?
Reach me, and I am here.
I use that voice, too. I actually get a voice changer.
Oh, God. You hear this, Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice? Batman needs a new voice changer. It needs to sound like Olmec.
Yeah. I never actually watched the movie.
Well, I did.
I heard it wasn't very good.
Yeah, that was dumb. I enjoyed the movie. It definitely had its flaws, but, you know, I still enjoyed it. The people who didn't enjoy it were just really, like, all really whiny and complaining, and it's like, I'm a critic, so I must be cynical. I'd say just judge the movie on your own merits.
That could be they just didn't like it.
what happened during the battle.
Oh, that too. But
what, is he trying to break down the wall? Why? The dead, we were
overjoyed. To rebuild? Or maybe he's fixing it. It's hard to tell.
I don't see him fixing it, because like, it's broken at the exact spot he's hitting. He must have like chipped off the wall.
I must hammer this wall. For it is my escape. He unleashed his dark magic
on us. Oh god, there's so much dialogue in this world. He caused a massive wave to come down and crush the temple of water.
The water crushed the water. A wave comes to crush the temple of water.
The water
it's not much of a temple of water, that is it.
The temple of water got crushed by water. The water that it's. The temple of the jaguar withstood his power.
At least the earthquake knocking down the wind makes sense.
Yeah. Your husband should be honored to be chieftain. But Olmec,
oh wise one, it was never his desire to become chieftain.
It was default. Everyone died. Last man standing. The secrets it hid
inside brought him. I guess he really, literally is the last man.
Unless you count the guys or like women who were like praying earlier to summon Olmec. I'm not sure if those were I'm pretty sure those were guys.
I think they might just be wind up toys.
Actually, yeah, that's true. The death of our beloved daughter
weighs heavily upon him. You speak of this daughter as if it was a quest. Killed in the battle.
My husband insists that she was crushed beneath the boulders which destroyed the village walls. You
speak as though you pretty reasonable, if you ask me. I cannot help
myself. Why don't you punch the boulder like Chris Redfield in Resident Evil 5? That always works.
Maybe he should use that hammer to search in the rubble instead of destroying the wall that he needs to keep him in shelter.
Yeah, he is just destroying his wall. Alright. So Olmec, with his slow stoned legs, or heavy weighted stone legs, moves. Alright, so nothing changed with her, so just keep walking.
Walking super slow back to the skull. Oh, ghost. Oh, by the way, they blink in and out of existence, so sometimes you have to wait for them to pop up again.
It'd be nice. I mean, I feel like this guy's not that threatening on a battlefield. I feel like you can just run away from him.
And they're all bald, too, like Kratos. Maybe they were all Kratoses.
Maybe they just got shaved. The great Quetzalcoatl created a massive whirlwind that knocked off all of our hair.
Because we were all wearing wigs. You see that guy that's now chieftain? He's also wearing a wig.
He sheared a mammoth and buried the Temple of Hair in a giant mountain of hair.
Oh, speaking of the puzzles here, I thankfully did not have to look up a guide for this, but some of the stuff was somewhat subtle. Someone had some animatronics installed.
This must be the Jaguar Temple. This must
a sacrificial he seriously just said it was the Jaguar Temple.
thanks for noting that.
You will be able to enter the Jaguar Temple if you give these two things. This
hey, look,
must be
the
Jaguar
Temple.
There's
yeah, I'm guessing the heart that doesn't bleed is like a stone heart.
Something like that. You know, there's like observation, and then there's voiced observation. Like when it's a text thing, it's kind of like, you know, maybe they're just saying it in their heads. But when you actually hear them say an observation, it's like, oh, no shit.
Yeah, you have to think. Here's the Temple of Wind, I guess.
All the corpses. Temple of Wind. Oh, see, that was different. Nobody told him it was the Temple of Wind.
Yeah, boulders are no match for me. Much but I'm like going to use as little effort as possible to move them.
Much like how Chris Redfield had no trouble with boulders.
This guy seems more Leon Kennedy to me.
Your parents miss you greatly. I will take
this looks like an opening to a movie where it's like, living under the god, and she'll become like the goddess's like assistant.
Why did this of all things have to be animated?
I don't know. It was just I don't know. It just was. Cause 3D's cool.
We're going to Disneyland! See? That is Disneyland.
Kotlkyu, my daughter, you have returned from death.
Fool! Quote, return from death? Within the temple. Had you not been so stubborn and full of self-pity,
Have you not been a fucking idiot and looked in the temple, she might have been alive.
Yeah, like, it wasn't even like that. It was entirely buried in boulders. There were two boulders.
Yeah, and he could have used his hammer to break those, but no, he's gonna focus on the wall. Let's see.
That's what I'm saying, man. Look at, like, he goes back to breaking the wall. He's not even gonna talk to his daughter at all. He's like, I'm sorry, my wall-breaking duties have to be filled.
Sorry, I was hoping my daughter would have died. So
my wife wanted a window put in here so she could get a good view of the falls.
Oh, thank you, old man.
Oh, that's a good point. You have brought hope back. But there's no windows ever anywhere else. As
long as we have I'm a stonemason, but I dreamed of being an interior decorator.
And this thing called a window sounds like a magical idea. I will be famous.
I will patent it.
All right, so we talked to a little girl right here.
Yeah, there she is. Precious little one. Is that like a squid toy she's playing with?
Oh, wait, is it?
Child,
I can't tell.
Squid.
Why were you in the temple?
The shiny rock. It's pretty, and I like the music, too.
Shiny rock?
Yes, it's a big crystal. Like the ones father makes into jewelry. He made a scary mask before, and a necklace, and a lot of rings.
What music do you speak of, little one?
The gongs. Sometimes I can get a few of them to make the same sound. It's fun!
Goodbye. I shall now raid the temple for items.
As I am Olmec.
Yield to Olmec!
Got some nice balancing skills, being able to walk on that. It doesn't look like an even surface. What is the, is that a person?
Yeah,
who's lying dead there?
Those are dead people.
Oh.
Gruesome.
Also, that totem pole is pretty strong to withstand like Olmec's weight, however heavy he is.
Ah, sound system.
Gongs are used to make music.
So now we gotta match all of them to, like, vibrate at the same time to shatter the stone and, well, the crystal, to say.
Oh, I see.
I don't know why that would shut off the other ones. I guess the vibrations, like, clashed with each other.
Could be. Alright, I'm seeing the order you have to do, so it's just one of those, like, Simon games.
Olmec will make these all ring.
Oh, it actually is by size. I didn't even notice the minute differences between some of them.
Oh. Whoa!
The wind totem.
Okay. Just walk over that woman's body again.
Yeah, he could have crushed them like a
dead space. He must have, like, grounded into the ground. He must have, like, blood all over his feet.
Either that or he's the lightest thing ever, but yet the slowest moving thing ever.
Yeah, that somehow.
I mean, he is a god. I don't know why I decided, like, hey, maybe I can put the wind totem in that, block.
Well, it does have, like, an indentation, which I'm not sure why it has that, because there's no similar indentation in the statue.
Nope. Oh my god, when you find out, like, what the thing I'm missing is, it's gonna be, like, either, like, frustrating or, like, really funny.
Were you supposed to go to the other temple?
No. There's a little area that I didn't realize you can go to, so I spent mostly the entire game trying to figure out what I was doing wrong.
I see.
And I was like, there was a solution right here, I just needed to know about this area. And it wasn't, well, it was sort of hidden.
Silenin. Excellent names these guys have.
They're Nin unproven. Was this but your first battle?
What a noob!
What was your station as warrior, spirit?
You kinda suck, Zillinen.
Apparently they only have, like, so little warriors. Like, damn, this village is small. And they worship a god? I'd expect more. Actually, there were more, it's just most of them died.
Your courage at such a young age is honorable. Walk with head held high.
But I'm dead. For getting pwned in the first battle, cursed him for eternity.
Seems reasonable.
And then here we meet.
I guess the falling boulders put them on pikes. Oh, is that Quetzalcoatl?
Yeah. Quetzalcoatl.
Quetzalcoatl has desecrated the bodies of such honorable warriors.
Okay, so maybe there were more.
You cannot touch me. In death, I have gained much power. The souls of the shaven head upon me feed my...
The shaven heads. The shaven...
Oh, so that's their clan name, I guess.
The shaven.
Name of their tribe.
Perhaps I may find some magical talismans nearby.
Except it's not nearby.
I can't...
Well, I could only guess.
A tree going
lake of lava. Scalding lake of lava.
Move about, there's a spirit right there, but you can't go there unless the water gets a little drained. Or not drained, but you know, there's a path for you.
There's a lava there. You can drain the lava?
No.
Oh, I see.
You can't go back down there. The pot does nothing.
Oh, can you use the pot to carry the water, put it and pour it over the pour it
that'd
over the lava?
That'd be a long process, but logically yes.
Oh, by like Minecraft rules.
Oh wait, this line. Check this line.
Enough games. Yield before Olmec.
Come on.
Enough games, yield before Olmec. I love it. That's such a great line.
Kneel. Okay. Oh, right. So the wind totem's doesn't go in there?
Nope. And the wind temple's done, and I can't go into the jaguar temple yet. So I've just been like, oh, did I miss anything at all?
And you probably did.
So just in case.
Is that yarn? Like, what is that?
I think that's a pot.
It's a pedestal. I don't know. It's like a little thing of thread.
Yeah, it's nothing to say.
A spool of thread, excuse me. That's the correct word.
Yes.
The jewelry suits you well, widow.
I don't see no necklace.
Thank you, Olmec.
Widow.
You have brought much happiness.
That's how I address people that have been widowed.
Every time I see its reflection in the
good tidings, widow.
Good job, bachelor. Actually, no, that's not too bad.
Yeah, it's not quite as bad. How are you, daughter of murder victim?
How are you, wall smasher?
Yeah, that guy gets his own title.
Then you realize how slow Olmec walks, like even sped up, he's slow.
This looks pretty bad. Look at that guy floating there. He looks so silly in the sped up.
How do you die in the water?
He died floating above it, apparently. He was trying to concentrate.
It makes me think, like, if in Dark Souls you died in an awkward way that leaves your, like, souls in the water. Alright, so we keep moving, and I still don't know what to do. But I somehow managed to actually do it. There's a little subtle thing that I did not... Or, no, I can't even say I didn't notice. It was kind of like, it's really subtle. Is it this part? There's a thing I need to do here. There's a thing I need to do up there, but I didn't realize it because it wasn't exactly obvious, but I managed to figure it out somehow.
Is there something you can do with what you have already?
A little bit, and if I had known about another area. I don't know why I bothered coming back here considering it's all done. But, you know.
Figure if you ring the gongs in the opposite direction, it'll do something.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking, but... Clearly, it was not the case.
Jeez. This guy is like Donkey Kong, you know, when you get the hammer. Like,
when you speed it up, it does. You could even say that to like Olmec's walking.
Yeah. Blood that springs from a holy heart. Hmm.
Remember that husband that that old lady with the sour tongue was talking about?
Yeah.
It's her husband that we need the blood from.
He's holy, I guess?
Because he's a shaman.
Oh,
a witch.
Or a witch, yeah.
So it's fucking no clue. And I finally, like, magically figured this out. So tell me this, if this is, like, subtle or not. Like, it's like, how the fuck would you know to do this?
Yeah, I didn't initially think that you could walk up there, but I did realize it eventually. Wait, what? There was lava going there?
Well, the lava overflowed, and then it went into the water.
Huh.
The scalding lake of lava overflowed.
No great feat for one so mighty as Olmec.
Okay, Olmec, so we got you.
So I get blasted just to get down faster.
I love that. I am so mighty. he gets knocked on his ass again.
I am so smart. S-M-R-T. I mean, S-M-A-R-T. Spirit, what say you?
Hey, spirit. Not warrior or anything like the others.
He's got like a proper sword, too. This guy's ahead of his time.
Or is it a lance or spear?
It's a sword. Not sure.
Because I can see like the hand, like below the handlebar, it's like longer, too.
Yeah. You might be right.
The shaven head Otunmi?
Otunmi?
What was your station as warrior, spirit?
In my prime.
These spirits have like a constellation on their bodies.
Do you say your age relative to people?
Yes, I am younger than Hitman, and Hitman is older than me.
I am younger than Hitman, but older than my older sister. Or older than my younger sister.
And younger than my father, who is older than my mother, but younger than my great-grandmother, who is younger than my grandpa. Images
carved in stone. I see.
Very informative.
Oh, is this some kind of puzzle? Oh, yes, I see it graying out, okay.
Yeah, but unfortunately I don't know the combination to it, so it's just like, oh, hey, maybe.
Fish.
Trying to be an
architect. I didn't even get a good look at that. Is it fish? The guy there?
Oh, don't worry, I'll slow down the puzzle. During the solving.
Do you just have to figure it out, or?
You have to put in a certain pattern, and it all means something.
Is there a way for you to figure out what the pattern is, or do you have all the information you need right now?
No, you gotta talk to, like a fish. Who would know about fish here?
Oh, I see, the fisherman.
But I didn't know that, of course, at the time of this, so it's just like, oh, well, let's see if anybody knows. Or perhaps.
As a fisherman,
there we
you
go.
Must be familiar with the water temple. What do you know of the carvings that mark the inner wall?
Isn't it outer wall?
Sacred place.
Yeah, that's kind of weird.
To pray within the cool walls. Speak Creed.
The movie Creed?
Yeah, I guess so.
What is the Creed?
Adonis Johnson.
Apollo Creed.
Living in America.
What? You babble, Shade?
What the fuck you talking about?
Creed.
He can tell us anything, but not this. And it's not like we didn't gain his trust or anything.
Do you have to talk to his wife to figure it out?
Yep, okay. That's the next step.
He was always going on about that Creed of fishermen in his life.
Or either about the movie Creed.
This is so unnecessary, he could have just told us.
Yep. So it's like, water life. Fucking Tetsuo.
At least Quetzalcoatl's not making any more progress while we're doing this. Or really doing anything, he's just standing there.
He's just standing there watching Olmec run around and is like, this is great. If only I had popcorn.
He's just like, this is excellent entertainment watching this guy walk back and forth, try to like talk to these spirits that can't really talk.
Tired of it. Literally, his own downfall is because of him. He is his own downfall because he's just watching Olmec undo everything he's going to do.
Yeah, I think he's too entranced watching that guy knock down the wall.
I have spoken with the spirit.
Maybe that's his job. That's why he's doing it.
Is he well?
The spirits are.
He is dead.
Well, he's dead as shit.
Words and thoughts. When I asked of the carvings of the temple, he repeated the word Creed to me. Do you know what this word means?
He was my favorite boxer growing up.
Creed. He would often chant it to himself during prayer.
Okay, so God's beer, water, fish, basket.
God's eye is high above. Spear the water quickly, for if the fish lie unaware, your baskets will be filled with the warrior's bounty.
Repeat the fish.
Yes, Holy One. It is this.
Yes, Holy One.
When God's eye is high above.
So obviously double checking and only and also because the repeat
for
word
if
lighted
the
up.
Fish lie unaware.
All right, pretty simple.
Yes, now let's see if I can actually do it, which I will. If Olmec would hurry his
Olmec.
Ass up.
It looks like I'm like some kind of really badly made automaton.
It probably is.
Some sort of golem.
Looks like he's walking on those like those fashion roads where it's like trying to show off how the new fashion.
Like those arms are swinging even though they're made of stone.
Well, he's got to be able. He's got to be able to pick up stuff, right? All right, so sun.
Spear the water, fish. Right down it. Yeah.
Oh, there we go. And now the fountain, the temple starts pissing.
It'll drain, I guess.
For some reason. So the water temple gets filled? Well, I guess that's why they call it the water temple.
Well, it's... Why? How would it... Ah, that makes no sense. It has a drainage system?
Yes! This primitive society has a drainage system. Oh, now the door opens. I was like, what the fuck?
A ruby fish. Its blood-like coloring must indicate something important.
Oh, God. There's a funny joke with this item that we'll see later.
The water totem.
This really feels like we're being in a Zelda game, minus all the action.
The water temple. Oh, jeez.
The wind, the water.
Now I must go through 5 floors of annoying puzzle solving.
Thank goodness that wasn't the case, but we did go through, like, 9 chapters of it.
I always have the iron boots.
Yeah, Olmec would probably sink to the bottom. If only he could take them off.
Take his whole body off?
Can't use the ruby fish on the old hag. She'd probably take it. Oh, here's a... Here's what the red ruby fish is for, just listen.
That looks like a red herring. I appreciate the gift.
Oh, nice.
When my husband found them in his net, he would curse his luck. He claimed they are useless things that simply take up space.
Oh!
So it is a literal red herring.
Yes, what a burn!
Nice.
I was like, oh, fuck you, game, that was clever. Because I was like, hey, maybe I can use it to feed the jaguar or something, but no, it's a fucking joke. Take that, player.
I wish you could throw it to the jaguar mouth and it'd be like, yum.
Unfortunately, this does nothing, so fuck you. Let's see, how long will this take until I figure out what to do?
Well, this is the part where you don't know the area you had to go to?
Nope. And you'll kind of see why. Oh, jeez. Oh, and you can drain the temple again. Like,
again? Like, isn't the water already out of it?
Yes, but I guess it fills up like a toilet. This is our sewage system.
The water temple is the sewage system.
Well, it would be, wouldn't it?
Maybe.
I mean, it flushes. Let's see, what does Quetzalcoatl have to say?
Hey.
And you can actually talk to him. And look, he's a snakehead.
Huh.
So he is what you said he was.
You follow your god's commands like the dog that you are. Go back down to your followers and wait for your death as they do. You are powerless against
Looks like,
You're just gonna have to wait, unfortunately. I'm kinda useless.
You're gonna have to wait as I do my aerobics exercise up here. Well, say that to my face! Fox only found
me down.
This nation no items.
They are loyal to none but themselves. Soon after my death, they stop offering...
So basically, this god is basically like any other god who's like, oh, they didn't pray to me, so you can go eat a dick!
Why have yeah. You left your he's actually striking back against them.
God to return to this land is a disgrace. I am more than a god. I am a warrior.
The warrior?
I'm pretty sure that's not more than a god. Just throwing that out there.
Unless he's a warrior god, or a god warrior. But not just a warrior.
And then what? When there is nothing left to conquer, what will you do?
I grow with the power of the souls I consume. When this world had been...
So basically this guy did not think his plan through, where he'll be alone.
I
Yeah.
Kind of like Randall Savage.
Yeah. Although I guess he actually made a mistake. Like, he didn't actually count on... He didn't actually count on his, gravity machine destroying the world. Yeah, now I'm just using you to get down the stairs.
Yeah, that's true. Because literally, it is a lot faster than waiting for Olmec to walk down. Let's
yeah,
see.
Pretty much anything is faster than waiting for Olmec to walk down.
The snail walks faster than Olmec.
Yeah, and it doesn't even walk.
Waiting for Duke Nukem to load is faster than... Or Duke Nukem Forever to load is faster than Olmec.
Waiting for Duke Nukem to get released is faster than Olmec watching.
Waiting for Mighty No. 9 to get released is faster than Olmec.
Oh, don't even joke about that.
Even though it is kind of getting released.
So. Showing them the totem?
No, apparently the totems do nothing.
Really?
Nope, they have no idea what the totems are about.
Huh.
Otherwise, I would have slowed down the footage and they'd have said something interesting, because Olmec's just like, I should not use this on them. It would not be of use if I used it on them. This
hey,
would
here.
Not be very useful.
Hey, guy. Hey, maybe you should bash the wall with this totem instead.
And then, like, break the game. Oh, thank goodness, like, Sanitarium isn't those, like, roguelike games where if you use the items wrong, it's, like, you're dead end.
Right. Or the old text adventures.
So, thank goodness for that. Like,
It would make it much harder to let's play if it were a text adventure.
Yeah, it would be. What was it?
I've tried to play some like old text adventures, like one called The Creeping Horror, which is like a Lovecraft-inspired.
Oh, really? Is that on Steam?
No, it's just you can just download it for free.
Oh, okay.
It's a DOS game. And yeah, it's a sort of Lovecraft-inspired thing, and you run around a university trying to like... find this mysterious stone to kill this lurking horror.
Give me my stone.
Yeah, and then there's this like hooligan who wants to kill you, and some other guy who tries to kill you, and just like everyone's after you for some reason. And then I saw Beneath the Titanic, which is actually released as a free text adventure, but it's very difficult.
Oh wait, here it is. Check this out.
Oh wait, what?
There's a fucking house.
That's
to the
invisible.
Far left.
You can't see that.
There's no path, and you can see my frustration as I whirl around. Olmec is angry. The air around it smells of magic. So
great.
Basically, I could have solved this game like 30 minutes early if I had I known about this area. But no, the Jaguar Temple blocks the road, and it looks like a dead end to me.
Yeah, you can't see it.
I say that the end is near. Quetzalcoatl will destroy us all. Lest I find one.
The Pod of Might?
Bring me the Pod.
The Tree of Might?
What name do you go by, Ancient One?
My name is Tezcatl.
You know, old men don't appreciate it when I address them as Ancient One.
Last hope.
Well, by the way, may this be of no use to you, Chosen.
Destroy this devil.
The plants of Dark Soul have infested my garden.
God, I can't believe you.
Greetings, Chosen.
Chosen, you must hurry.
It contains the seeds
I can't believe, like, your village in Fallout 2 can, like, still die even if you took the fastest route to beating the game.
Why are you consorting with prostitutes in the den, Chosen One? We need your help.
Oh, does he actually say that?
No.
But
you can do all kinds of silly things when you have a quest in Fallout 2.
I haven't finished it.
It's heat.
That was the one of that and New Vegas I didn't finish.
I never finished Fallout 2. Fallout 2 is just too hard.
And long compared to 1.
Yeah, it's very, very long.
But at least you're getting your money's worth.
There's a lot of stuff you can do, but it's not obvious how to do it.
Yes. And then there's like limitations like what level requirements. Like your skills.
I feel like you just get wrecked.
You do.
You get into a fight and like if you get a crit, it's like, yeah, okay, no big deal. But if they get a crit, they just kill you instantly.
No,
so you're just waiting to die?
Yeah, Fallout 2, it's against the players. They didn't want, like, in the first game where all your allies are dead by the time you get to the Master. So they made the allies more useful, because
right.
I noticed that they did a lot more, they hit a lot more often, and they hit harder more often.
Yeah.
And it's just like, my character's just here, and it's like, what the fuck?
Except for Vic, who sucks.
Vic the Dick.
How about that guy?
Was he the bartender?
No, he's the merchant who he had to save from Metzger, the, slaver.
Oh, the first companion you can find?
Well, that's Sulik.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I don't remember Vic, because, I don't.
I just remember the, dialogue that you, the special dialogue that you got from the village elder, if you chose a stupid character.
Oh, what was it?
Find Vic. Vic, go to Klamath. Klamath. And you can, like, hear her, like, losing hope as she talks. She's like, oh, we really have to trust our fate to this guy.
To an idiot. Go to the Dagobah system. There you will find Yoda. However, if I anger him
enough with my spell, he will spend... Very non-specific instructions. By the way, why do they say system when they mean planet?
I don't know. That's a good question, actually.
It always irritated me. Like, it's just one planet. Is there really one planet to a solar system in this universe?
It's not that I was. It's not like system was a wrong thing, but Dagobah is a planet, not a system.
Yeah, and he just happens to land on the right part of the planet. Like, geez, it's an entire planet, and he just chooses the right spot.
Anyway, so we've been talking with this guy about what to do against Quetzalcoatl, and he's gonna sacrifice himself, because it's a smart thing, and make him spend his energy on him. The statues
sheltered within the temples. I sound like I have asthma. Purity of
the gods themselves. The gods themselves. Quetzalcoatl fears
them. I am the Lord, Jesus Christ.
Oh, jeez. Your wife
mourns for you, witch. She knows what I plan and fears the future without
me. Oh, don't worry, she'll join you soon. She Dark, has I know. Seen our two
warriors die at the hands of Quetzalcoatl. Foul-tongued crone, I will send you to meet your husband. Smack. Me.
Dies. Alright, so we go. So finally, after done talking...
Can you get past him?
Let's... I should be able to. But apparently...
He's just blocking the way.
Move! Move, old one! Let Olmec pass through!
Move, bitch! Get out of the way!
Oh, apparently this guy has a... Oh. I have found your daughter, Mason. It is time for me to undergo the... Oh, yeah, the challenge thing. You have to do two trials. One is finding his daughter, and the other is to list the age of all the other guys.
Huh.
Enough groveling, chieftain! Get on with it!
Alright, bitch, yes. Shut up and...
Get on with it!
There are Get on with it!
The first, an act of bravery and heroism. You've already shown that by returning my daughter to me. Second, you must recite the names of the warriors who have come before you, in order of their lineage.
Why the fuck should history matter? They're dead! Alright,
it's tradition!
So here's my quest to go and find the names, and you can play along and see, but I get it, I own, like,
Are you talking to them all again?
Yes, because I'm like, oh, fuck, I gotta, like, remember
I hope you sped this up.
Oh, please tell me I did. I mean, compared to everything else, you think I would have sped this up? I'm pretty sure I did.
Oh, no.
Where is it? I think I might not have sped this up, so people can actually also try to guess. Or at least use this as a guide.
So we've got Omatok. Omatok is the youngest. And then
younger than Ted Talk.
And then Tepic Talk. Ted Talk.
Tepic Talk.
Ted Talk, yeah.
What name did you... Omatok. So he's the younger one than the fisherman.
Omatok is younger than the fisherman.
But he's older than Celani, though.
It goes Xylan and Omatok and then Tilatok.
And I'm like, oh wait, I know who this one is. This one's the Zili.
Yeah, that one's the youngest one.
It's just remembering the names is already like one thing.
The youngest warrior, okay.
Okay, goodbye. I just needed to ask you about your age. Jeez. What is wrong with these people?
Couldn't you just line them up and be like, how old are you?
You know, that'd be funny and logical. But I guess they can't move.
Yeah, maybe not. Mixcoatl is the eldest, okay. Huitzilop?
Witzwaddle. Ah.
Witzwaddle.
Imagine if you had to like pronounce the name correctly. Otherwise, the guy's like, "Nope, you don't pass."
Who are you talking about? Witzalop?
Great. How old are you? Tepetok.
Okay, so after Tepetok, this guy.
Younger than.
We already know what it is then.
Yeah. So I didn't look at all of them because you just need to look at 5 out of the 6.
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, well, that guy is not needed. So I think I double checked this one just in case because I was like, wait, this is a war chief? That's a war chief?
I'm forgetting the names. So we have Zeelin in at the bottom, and then
Omatok,
and then Tepetok, and then Mixquaddle is at the top.
Mixquaddle's at the top, and then
Hui whatever is.
He was a young fifth. Second after.
Is like the.
Yeah, we'll see the answer here.
All 6 names of the.
Yes.
Then let us begin, Olmec.
Starting with the youngest and ending with the eldest. Thank goodness it wasn't the other way around.
Zilonen.
Sounds like a spell. So I'm forgetting it at this point. I was like,
Omatok. So Omatok's older than him. And Tepetok.
Tepetok. Come on, Tepetok it.
Then Sentotal, and then Huitzop. Huitzalop. That's such a silly name.
By the way, that was a guess right there, so I almost screwed it up.
You are most wise, Grand Old.
Just note, I did not write this down, I swear to God.
Yeah.
I was like, I can remember this.
It's good they give you the names.
To protect you from the mighty. Oh, imagine if you had to type it and you misspell it.
Yeah.
That would have been terrible. Blood and the magics of the earth. This will create a temporary barrier. Let's find your stone flesh with my blood in the magic. Yeah, this will create a temporary barrier.
How long will it last?
Not long. You must be swift in your
quest. Olmec being
lasts
swift.
Lasts exactly 32.37 seconds.
Blood of the holy.
Hey, they just exploded the here. Warrior. And look, there's the dolls there. The hey, I think those are women. Wait, no. And power.
The one guy's out of sync with the others.
One
didn't
of them
whine, didn't wind,
old.
They didn't wind him well enough.
This noble
nope.
Warrior from the harsh elements. It is done.
Too bad we can't use this shield against Quetzalcoatl. We have to go the long way. Lies in your hands.
Huh. So what do we need to protect him from the elements for?
Ah, what was the thing?
Oh, we need to go to get the tree, okay.
From the scalding lake of lava. Lava.
Great.
Love, I mean. Oh! Excuse me, pardon me.
That is a silly animation.
Whew.
This must be the pod of might, the water.
Don't drop it now.
The pod of might.
Dragon Ball Z, the tree of might.
Oh, jeez, that was such a silly movie.
Evil Goku!
I eat steroids that make me stronger.
I have the pot of might, old one. Here, work your magic.
Very good. Thank you, sacred one. I will begin.
It almost
at
looks
once.
Like a Dragon Ball. Anyways, now he gets the fuck out of the way. He just
I
eats it? That's the magic?
Fulfill my destiny.
I just wanted a full meal before I die.
Save the village.
Wait, it was my favorite before the lava came.
Wait, maybe that was the steroid of, like, the tree. He's trying to do the Bardock thing.
Maybe.
You come on my leg!
Your Mortal Kombat bullshit does not affect me. I know the cheat codes.
No, you
I like how they subtitle that. Very important that we know.
The sound effect?
Oh shit, he died.
What a combat.
Mortal Kombat
fatality. Surely, perhaps.
An unwise thing? You do it afterwards, but you have to ask permission from him.
Although honorable in your sacrifice, the village is still in danger, old one.
In other words, you fucked up.
Exactly.
Mask.
Mask? What mask do
isn't
you
he wearing one?
Death mask. His power.
At least it's not a death note.
From it.
Where is it?
It all comes full circle.
Below the maze.
Oh, so it's the maze in the Jaguar Temple?
Yeah. Well, actually, no. Yeah, so before we can collect his blood, we need to make sure he's actually dead.
Yeah.
Which I find very weird.
His blood flows freely from wounds that will not heal.
Cause he's dead!
Oh, excuse me.
A sacrificial bowl filled with the blood of the witch doctor.
Alright.
Alright, how do we get the other thing?
Well, remember a place that we haven't been to yet? I think I'm a... Yes, I'm going
there. Oh yeah, inside his hut, okay.
Because he was blocking the way. Right. Damn it! Out of Olmec's way! Oh look, a literal heart shape crystal.
Get out of the way, or I will grind your bones to dust.
If I had the bones to do it.
Is he wearing sandals or something?
Yeah. Stone sandals. They're rock solid.
Glad to see he's still,
flexible.
Still dressing casually for the summer.
Well, he probably doesn't... Well, to say he doesn't feel heat would be wrong. I mean, there was that whole...
The gods have a casual dress code.
Casual?
Olmec isn't really a god. He just fights for the gods.
Yeah, he's a messenger.
Something like that, yeah.
Alright, time to move my ass.
Hopefully.
At least he moves up the stairs faster than he walks.
Yeah.
Holy warrior, an honorable offering is made.
I have to wonder though, how many times do you have to make like get blood and a heart to enter this temple?
Yeah, exactly how many people have to die every time you get in here.
Hey, I lost the keys inside the temple. Can someone make a sacrifice?
Yeah, can someone die, please?
Well, thank goodness the blood doesn't dry up that fast, otherwise,
You could have saved me a lot of time if you had just opened up.
Stone wheels, set to turn for some strange purpose.
Now try and figure out where the puzzle for this is, or the solution to it.
I don't know.
This is it's actually right in front of you, but it's quite subtle. Or, to say subtle wouldn't be right, it's just hidden. In sight. Thank goodness I sped this up. So
you could actually see what the solution was from in there?
Yes. Technically.
Okay. What?
She has poisoned herself and is dead!
How did she know? She hasn't been doing anything.
No. Her husband told her that he was going to commit suicide, and so she poisoned herself.
Yeah, but like, what did...
You mentioned a mask.
She always knew that.
The witch also spoke of a mask. He called it a death mask.
Is it the mask worn by Jim Carrey?
Oh, yeah.
Empowered by the god of Loki.
It was for King Quetzalcoatl.
He said, smoken! What does he mean?
What kind of magic, child?
I don't know. Ask Father. He knows.
God, this is like every character's dialogue. It's just like, go to the next room to ask the person.
And then go to the next room to ask that. It's like, just go to the end of the line.
Just give me the information. Stop hammering the wall. If you haven't destroyed it yet, you're not going to.
The death mask?
Look, you're just not going to break it. You're not man enough to break it. The wall is stronger than you.
Oh, Olmec's just punch it, and then it'll get destroyed, and he's like, there,
now
you can stop hammering the wall.
The archaic spell of spiritual strength upon it. We thought it would ensure a speedy journey to the afterlife for our respected king.
A death mask?
That spell was forbidden by the elders. It grants a destructive force which can corrupt even the noblest of souls. He must be using the mask for his power.
My profile icon looks funny with my mouth open.
It is sealed in his tomb.
That's the mad Olmec. Oh, okay. There's just no way to get to it.
Or so he says. So now it's like, I was trying to find out, like, what's the combination of the temple? The answer's like right in front of me somewhere. And it is. So I tried to see if I could collect more blood from him. Which obviously I did not need, because the character knows.
Hey, Quetzalcoatl, do you know the code to the Jaguar Temple?
Hey, Quetzalcoatl, I'm gonna talk to you. Goodbye. That's like the ding-dong ditch of the Aztecs. Just like, Hey, Quetzalcoatl! He'll be like, what do you want? And you just turn around and giggle.
What a dick. Do you see the answer yet?
That's on the sides.
It's on the side of the stairs. I was like, fuck you, game. This is like humongous entertainment puzzle quality.
Yeah.
But I'm like, oh, you know what? Thank goodness, because I didn't want to bother with it. Oh, and then the worst part of this, guess what happens?
What?
I put the solution in the wrong direction.
Oh, so you end up putting it reverse?
Yes. So I'm like, ugh.
Oh, because they mark the, like, steepness of the various things. I see.
But it's like, I had no clue which way they wanted me to put it in, so I had to screw up once for this. Thank goodness I sped it up right here.
Dun dun dun.
Dun, 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 dun,
it must be really awkward for everyone has to solve this puzzle every time.
Yes, it is. Speedrunners, beware.
Yeah, just the Aztec guy that's like, okay, turn the wheels.
Oh, so which way are we going to turn it, though? Oh, fuck it, let's put it to the left.
Okay, reset the wheels.
Huh.
You're a what? Your watch?
The symbols carved into them mark this as a place of great magic.
Great magic. Stone. So I'm like, wait, maybe I got it backwards. Okay, so it's like, oh, fuck it, let's do this. Da 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 da. Switch that. Fuck you. Switch you. Turn you off.
Eh.
It's like, oh, thank goodness.
Yeah, you finally hear the little.
The Jaguar's power is revealed.
Revealed or released?
I guess.
Optic blast.
It's a Triforce.
Tri-beam attack.
God, I hope you've solved this area.
Yes, I do. Hey, it shoots a red laser. Hopefully it doesn't.
Okay.
Hopefully it doesn't shoot a brown laser.
Alright. What got destroyed there?
A beam of light. Some great magic.
Yeah, you'll see.
Work here.
Fuck you, you destroyed Olmec's statue. Olmec is mighty.
Oh, it's Quetzalcoatl's statue, right?
Was it a Quetzalcoatl? I thought it was Olmec.
Yeah, it was Quetzalcoatl's statue.
Actually, yeah, it was a Quetzalcoatl.
He was like, the reward that he gave them was death.
Fuck you, Quetzalcoatl. This is what I think of your statue.
Exactly.
So I gotta put it all in the right, area.
Alright, there's the water temple there.
So, in order to get to the maze of this, they have to sacrifice somebody and destroy a statue, too.
And drain the water temple.
Oh, but Sue, it just falls through? Really?
He just jumped, he didn't look, he even looked.
This looks like
he just falls down.
Falls down Toy Story-like. He should have broken all his bones.
I guess he doesn't have bones.
Indiana Jones time.
Wait, what? Wait, this is a guy with a hat.
This is him. This is him, like dreaming about himself.
Huh.
You know, Max.
Right. The South American.
Yeah.
Expedition he took.
The expedition he took in South America. Yeah. So he's recalling parts of it.
Oh, I get it.
Because the scenes feel similar to him, because he's traveling through his mind. Hey, I'm gonna poke this in the eye.
Oh, you inconsiderate jerk.
Oh, I cannot guard what I cannot see.
This Nobody's like, blinded me.
This looks like something you'd see in a Serious Sam game. Like an area you'd go into.
With a lot more shooting, though.
Yep. Oh yeah, spider webs rip off that easy and don't stick to your hand.
Yeah, it's kind of bizarre.
Hey, camcorder, he's gonna make a vlog. Oh wait, no, it's a camera. Wait, how'd he take? Never mind. Oh wait, is this the line I was thinking of? Oh god, this line's really funny.
DNA
If
initiated.
Come on, come on. Hold together, you son of a bitch.
Molecular cohesion affirmative.
Yes!
What is his music?
That was so fun. Just wait till you see me do something with it at the end. It's kind of funny. It was unintentional too. Oh, and then that leads us back to the beginning of the game.
Huh.
Of the opening to Silent Hill. If Harry crashed the car. This seems familiar.
Well, fear of blood tends to create fear of the flesh.
Alright, so here's goodness. A maze. Which I think most people would not care to watch, because it's just like, oh, how does he get out of here? It's like, oh, well, fuck it.
Oh, he avoids the little pink blasty things?
Yes, and obviously they do not kill you, otherwise, because there's no death in this game.
Right.
So now these things, you gotta shuffle around and such. Oh, you actually press the individual buttons on it, which is very...
It looks like he's pressing both the outside buttons at once.
Yes, he is. And that opens a little shortcut thing. It takes me a little while to figure out, like, how this whole maze works out. And I got stuck at one point, too.
The wall-less maze. An excellent idea.
I could not possibly jump through that.
Created by Aztec Innovation.
Man, this magical stuff. They invented teleportation.
It's pretty good. And time travel.
Go here and... look at this.
Little timing puzzle there.
Oh, look at that. He can't jump over it. Because that's... Like, really? Olmec is mighty. Olmec is strong. Olmec cannot jump.
Yeah, not even an inch.
Or even like... Ugh. It's weird.
Oh, you gotta go back down there.
And then I'm like...
God, where do you have to go?
And I'm like, God damn it. Yeah, I gotta go to the left of that area. So I decided to get zapped just to speed up the return.
Yeah.
Yeah, this part was not exactly the most enjoyable part of the game. I gotta say.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it.
Especially with how slow Olmec is.
You're just bopping around, trying not to get hit by these things. Like, yep. Movement-based puzzles in this thing is just, ugh.
And apparently I go back there again, because I think I can get past that, but what I didn't realize is that, no, you're just not... This area, you can't get past it. You're just destined to get hit.
You just have to go to the left, right?
Yeah, you have to go to the left. But you gotta trigger a few, like... gears and levers to move around, and there's like the perspective part of it where it's like I can't see where
it does seem difficult with that. Oh, you could do that. Okay.
So it's like, okay, that opens that. So it's like, where do I go? How do I get there? Perspective. It's like if you were actually here in this area, like in first person, I think it wouldn't be as difficult.
Right. It became a dungeon crawler all of a sudden.
Yes, it did. So it's like, what do I do, There's also, a thing I'm missing to do. Which I actually don't remember because, I don't like this part. It's not very fondly remember.
I wouldn't remember it.
Oh, like, this is
Wait,
what you're supposed to do. You can trigger the statue. So
you gotta shake his hand?
So that thing would, lift off. It's like, oh, really? I was...
Oh, God.
Obvious, right?
Not that much.
Let's go over here. There's a little button here, obscured by the perspective, of course.
Right, a little lever.
Opens the door.
Oh, and you can just climb on the other.
And
okay.
This lever, I wonder what does it do? I should press it just in case. Ah, there we go. Prince of Persia.
How do I know this?
You think he'd know how to get through this, a lot faster?
The Death Mask of Quetzalcoatl.
So how does he destroy it?
First he grabs it and then fights a Quetzalcoatl with it. Well, of course he wears it too. Going spinal killer instinct on it.
No wonder he doesn't want to actually wear it. That thing looks so stupid.
Oh, well, we'll see what it looks like on him in this cutscene. Om. Now he starts running. Oh, and then check this transition. Santa! Oh no, it's a mummy!
Oh, my poor baby.
What?
An awful fall. I'm so glad you've come home.
Ooh, hey, honey, what you doing?
Well, of course, silly. You did want to come home, didn't you?
This is Wraith?
Yes.
Well, then that's that. Hush now, Max. When you fell down the chimney, you bumped your head and
fell down the chimney. Can you even fit in the chimney, like in real life? I wouldn't think so.
I feel like if you fell down the entire chimney and hit your head, that would be
death.
Fatal, yeah. Well, that car crash off that big of a slope would also be death.
Yes.
God, although, she's terrifying.
Although that car, you'd probably survive a little. Your chances of survival are better.
Perhaps.
Because of the airbags and stuff. Not that I'm saying it's guaranteed, but it helps a little bit more.
My car?
No, of course not, dear. You just bumped.
Yes, my car. I was driving and the brakes.
But Max, we've been waiting for you for so long. Don't leave now.
This scene is
I do not get what's going on.
Why me? Yeah, you'll see. Little Sarah, of course.
Little Sarah.
Who else would it be, silly?
But that's impossible. Sarah is dead.
Sarah, Max is home.
Just watch it gets like
Max,
a little fucked up.
Home,
what? She floated?
She floats.
I didn't notice that, actually.
This is The Exorcist.
My God, Sarah.
Wait a minute, an urn? Oh my god.
No! You're dead!
That's fucking creepy.
Oh my god. What is wrong with her? Why is she moving like that? Her mouth.
Your tenacity is quite remarkable. Your doctor tells me that you should have died in the car wreck. I wish things could have worked out differently, Max.
Oh, I could.
You leave me little choice, old friend.
So apparently Morgan knows how to hypnotize Max or do something to where he thinks something is happening while he's in a coma.
I've worked much.
Suppose.
Too hard to
so he's like, oh well, Sarah's face melts off, goodbye, so you. Shit. You know what? I just want you dead. So I'm gonna pump poison into your IV. You definitely didn't see that coming.
No, I didn't. What?
That's like something
Earth?
From the Indiana Jones movie. Anyway, so this is the gauntlet, the final area in the game. But that'll be for next time.
Quetzalcoatl murdering an entire village. Morgan trying to kill me. Now I see the connection.
I still don't, by
the
way.
This is real.
Okay. I don't. I'm glad you understand what's going on, Max, because I certainly don't.
I just understand that we gotta beat the, thing, so...
The gauntlet, I guess?
Yes. So that'll be it for, this episode of, Sanitarium with your host, Wizward100, and, Hitman.
Took quite a turn.
Yeah, that part was just funny. But yeah, see you all next time on the final commentary of Sanitarium, where everything comes to a close and we can get some closure.
Later.
See ya.